Well, her debut album has become something of a modern classic. Songs in a Minor won 5 Grammys, 3 American Music Awards and 2 Soul Train Awards back in the hit year of 2001. She's currently touring the east coast of Australia, and yesterday I had the pleasure of going backstage at the Enmore Theatre in Sydney to speak with the singer-songwriter herself. Alicia Keys features in today's eSpot. Got a great story. You started playing music when you were 7 years of age. How and why?
How and why? I was drawn to the piano like as if something was pulling me. There was nobody that told me you must play. It was a personal thing that I just loved since I was really young.
Those of us who've got kids and we make them practice every day, is that a good thing or a bad thing to do?
Now let's clarify. I did have to be made to practice.
That's good, that's good.
You see, practicing and wanting, desiring were two different things. The desire to play was always there. Practicing is always tough.
Got a record deal when you were 16, which kind of didn't work out. Because what did they want you to do that you didn't want to do?
They wanted me to be everybody but who I was. They weren't even really interested in finding out who I was or listening to the, you know, the different steps that it took to come to the place where I really started making the music that I'm making now. They weren't interested in hearing it. They wanted me to be something that was already done and something that was easily marketable. And
satisfying is that? You know, you fought off one record label and you're finally doing what you wanted to do. Tell me about that feeling.
It definitely was a good feeling.
Come on, it's better than good. That's a lot better than good.
It's definitely a good feeling to know that I had, you know, stuck to what I believed in and triumphed for it. And the thing it was that I realized that, you know, no matter what you do and no matter how much, you know, how many records people said or how many amazing artists people work with, you know, you don't know what's going to happen. You do not know. Nobody knows. I don't know. You don't know. Nobody knows. And that was the thing that I really took in from that whole experience. They thought that nobody would get this music, and they got it.
Why? What did they think was so different, so unusual?
Well, it didn't really fit like radio format at the time. And I don't even know if it fits radio format so much now either.
But you create your own kind of format. That's what
I believe.
Great artists do.
That's what I believe. But a lot of people are very scared of that. You know, they're very fearful of something brand new or something different. And
they want something neat and packaged that they go, this year's model.
There you go. Absolutely. Like the car. Like, yeah. It kind of looks like last year's, but it has a new light.
With braids.
Exactly.
Last year's with braids. Next thing you're going to do is a movie. You're going to be a movie star. Philippa.
Sure.
Movie directed by, or produced by, Halle Berry.
Right, exactly.
She's a virtuoso pianist growing up in Harlem.
Exactly. She's half black and half white, and it's an incredible story.
Not dissimilar from yours.
Yeah, which is pretty funny, because I always said I didn't want to play myself, and come to find out, I'm kind of playing myself. But it takes place in the 40s, and it's different. It's very different from my life, obviously. Her mother was very overbearing. She was really wanted her to pass for white so that she could continue to play this classical music in those classical venues, and people were very hard on her because of that. And she really had to try to find her way in this world that really wants you to be a package, I guess.
Lovely to meet you. Congratulations
on
all your success.
Thank you so much.
You need to spend more time here in Australia.
Next
time,
so I agree. Should I move in?
Move. you move right in. Okay. Alicia Keys has covered this day. That's Alicia Keys. Her current album is titled The Diary of Alicia Keys. She played the Enmore Theatre last night in Sydney. It was completely sold out on stage for 100 minutes and rave reviews a couple more nights there before heading north to Brisbane for the weekend. She is a fantastic artist. What
good
a talent.
Voice. Great voice.
Great voice.
She sounds a little bit Whitney-ish.
A little bit Whitney, a little bit Aretha Franklin,
yeah,
Stevie
yeah.
Wonder, all that stuff thrown together. Just a great talent.
Okay.
And a nice lady.
Thank you, Richard.
Pleasure.
Now, what with Layton and Kim and Delta and Mark, there's a lot of talk lately about relationships in the news. We're going to be looking at the role of trust in relationships with Mia Friedman. That's coming up. But first, let's take a look at what's topping the singles and the album charts right around the country.